The Knight of Shrouds are traitor generals that sold their soul for eternal glory. Their reward, an eternity enslaved to the will of Nagash. In today's video, we're going to show you how to paint one of these, so let's get started. So, the first thing you need to do is undercoat the Knight of Shrouds, and as you can see here, we've undercoated ours with Korax White Spray, as this is necessary for this tutorial to get that cool spectral effect. So the next step is to start applying Nylac Oxide. We'll use this with a medium shade brush, and we'll be applying it all over the model. I will thin this down. I'll just get some on the palette first. So I'll probably add about 2 paintbrushes of paint and about 1 paintbrush of water. Should be nice and runny enough. And all we need to do then is just start applying it to the actual figure. So we'll just start on the top. We'll probably just keep it to the robes and the hands. Don't need to add it onto like the helmet or the chainmail. That'll be fine. So make sure when you're applying this, we're just covering it all over the robes to get that cool spectral effect. It doesn't matter if you get anywhere else because we'll paint over that later. If you notice the Nylac Oxide starting to pool inside the recesses, just use your brush just to wipe off some of the excess like so. Once you're happy with the Nylac Oxide, we're ready to start applying the glaze. And for this, we're going to be using Waywatcher Green. And just like before, we're going to use a medium shade brush. We're going to apply lots to the palette like we did before. A couple of paintbrushes worth. Probably a paintbrush of water as well, just to thin it down, just so it runs around a bit better. Load my brush up quite a bit there. Just try and get as much on as I can. And we'll just start slapping it on again. And as you can see here, like the last stage, it does start to pool in the recesses. We can just use our brush just to help get rid of some of that excess. Once the Weight Watcher Green's dry, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to begin highlighting. And for this, we're going to be using Orthman Grey, but we'll do it with dry brushing and edge highlighting. So we're going to use a medium dry brush. Just apply some of this onto the bristles, as we're going to wipe most of it off. We don't want to overload it too much. And as you can see here, I'm just going to wipe off as much as I can. It will still leave pigments on the brush, but it won't be too heavy and you won't get weird effects like streaks and stuff. So once you're happy with how much is wiped off, we'll just then begin highlighting the model with it. So I'll start with the cloak. I might start from the back actually. So we need to sweep it across the model and we need to slowly build that colour up. So we'll do this several times. And make sure you concentrate on the hard edges and the raised areas. With that dry brush complete, we're now going to move on to highlighting using Orthman Grey again. We'll use a small layer brush for this. We'll just add a little bit to our palette, a little touch of water, like so, and then we'll just twist it to a nice point just to get more control for those detailed areas, like that. So actually I'll start running this on a couple of key areas. So we've got things like the knuckles, like here, and also there's bits of flame at the bottom because his cloak merges into some ethereal flame. We'll just pick out some little bits on his hands like that, like the knuckles. And also the flame will just broaden those highlights out a bit more. You actually want the flame to look less rough, because unfortunately dry brushing will do that, and it's great, but actually with flame, we don't want that effect. With the Orthman Grey now highlighted, we're just going to finish off with using a little white scar as a final highlight on all the areas like the knuckles, and picking out some of the bits of the robes and the fire at the bottom as well. So for this, we'll use a small layer brush, just get some on our palette. Just dollop it down there, add a little bit of water to it, not too much, because we don't want it to be too runny. And just spin it round to a nice point, like so. Until you're happy that you've got a decent point on your brush. And then we will start highlighting. We'll just pick out just little areas, like knuckles and stuff. Don't have to go too mad. And also, there's like the back of the cloak, you've got a couple of tears, so we can just pick out some of those a bit. And then there's all the flame down here as well, so I'll just highlight those as well. With the white now highlighted, the spectral robe is completed. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move on to painting the cowl and the scabbard. And for this, for the most part, we'll use the same colours. Until the very end, the highlights will be different. So for the cowl and the scabbard, we'll be starting off with Rhinoctide. So I'll just get a bit on my palette. We'll need to thin this down a fair bit, actually, because it's quite a dark colour, so we don't want to make it too thick and goopy. Just thin that down with a couple of bits of water. I will get a bit of a point to my brush as well. like so. Spin it around, and then we'll start applying it. So the areas to focus on here, it's all his sleeves, like so. You've also got just a bit around here, around his hood. Just turn it around on the back, you're going down as far as these parts here, not what, just past the chainmail, these areas here. Let's just start applying that on. As this is thinned down, you get more control, and for this I recommend using a medium layer brush. With the base coat now applied, we're just going to run a shade over all those brown areas to darken it down. And for this, we're going to use Nawn Oil and a medium layer brush. The reason why I'm using a medium layer brush is just because it's got a smaller nib to it and it gives me more control. I'll just add a little touch of water to that. Just load the brush up. Don't overload it too much because there's a danger you might just splodge and get in the wrong areas. So let's start applying that onto the robes. So just take your time, let it run into the cracks. Just make sure you take care not to get it on any of the other areas as well. With the shade applied and we've given it plenty of time to dry, we're going to move on to the highlighting stage. And for this, we're going to use Dubal Brown. We're going to do this on both the scabbard and the cowl. It's not until the next stage that we'll substitute with different highlights just to represent different textures. But up to this point, it's always been the same for those two areas. So I'll just get a nice bit on my palette, get it to a nice point, add a bit of water as always, want to thin it down. But not too much. Still want it to have a lot of that pigment in it. So just twist the bristles like so until you're happy, until you've got a decent point. Like so, and then we'll start applying that highlight. So I'll just run it around the edges a bit, around here, like so. And in some areas like the sleeves here, you can just use the edge of your brush. And also we've got the scabbard at the front here, and again, got a nice hard edge here, so you can just run it down the side of your brush like that. But when you get up to the center, there's a couple of corroded bits, so just run your brush around that. If you do splodge, just tidy it with a bit of Rhinox hide. Once all those areas have been highlighted with Dubal Brown, we're just going to start finishing off the cowl, and for this I'm going to use Baneblade Brown and I'll use a small layer brush. Now there's a danger sometimes when you're highlighting that you're actually highlighting over the previous colour, so for this I'm using a smaller brush. I'm just going to take my time and try and do those highlights a little bit thinner. So I'll just get it to a nice point, spin it around like so. I'll just concentrate, do it from the back because there's more of an area there for you to see. And I'll just start picking it out. And these just need to be a little bit thinner. Just take your time. And if you do make any mistakes, just paint over using the previous colour. Also, as a cool top tip, just to make it look ratty, if you, instead of doing a nice thin highlight all the way across, just do a little bit of a jump sometimes, just so it gives a bit of a ratty effect. With the cowl now finished and highlighted, I'm just going to finish off the scabbard, and for this I'm going to use Tuscar Fur, and I'll use a small layer brush. Just like what I did in the previous step, just thin it down, get it to a nice point, twist it round, and we'll just start applying that highlight. And again, if you can, just run your edge of your brush down the side, that will give you a nice sharp highlight. To give a cool scratchy effect on leather, what you can do is just flick your brush in a little bit as well, you have to be really careful, do a couple of like, what I like to call ghost attempts, and then eventually just bring your brush down and just do like little lines like that. Do it on an area like here, that just helps give it like an old battered leather effect. With the scabbard now highlighted and all those browns nearly finished, all I'm going to do now is just run a bit of Sabrite Green as a dry brush just at the base of the cowl. For this I use a small dry brush, got my Sabrite Green. It's worth getting a new bit of tissue as well because you don't want any cross-contamination from any other colours because it might still be a bit wet. So once you're happy and you've loaded the brush up enough and you've wiped it off, obviously want to keep some of that pigment on there, we'll start dry brushing it on. I'll do the back again just so you can see clearly. What I'm just going to do is just gently run it around the bottom. What it'll actually do is just give it a weird ghostly effect, like really spectral. And there we have it. The cowl and scabbard are finished, and you can see it's got a cool ghostly effect to it. So the next step we're going to do now is start painting all the metallics. And for this, we'll do the silvers first. So I'm going to use a lead belcher. I'm going to pick out the sword, the helmet, the chainmail, and also the fence that's at the bottom of the base. So I'm using a small base brush for this. And as always, just thin the paints down. Just get a load on the palette like so. Add a touch of water. Actually, with it having a white undercoat, you could probably water it down a bit more. Because once you put normal oil over it, you won't notice those white bits showing through. But it's up to you. There's no right way to do that. We'll start applying it. I'll start on the helmet first. So we've got the area here, like the helmet, like I said. We've also got a sword to do. So all that area at the top. Then you have the chainmail. So there's a few areas of chainmail just here. You've got a couple of areas at the back here as well. There's also the nice wrought iron fence at the bottom. Pick out all those areas. Not at the very bottom because that will be stonework. And then, of course, it's got a little hourglass here as well, so we'll do that silver. And when doing the fence, just be really careful and try not to get it on the ghostly effect. Take your time. With the lead belcher now applied and dry, we're going to move on to doing some shading. And for this, I'm going to use Agrax Earth Shade, as this will give it a cool, rusty effect. I'm going to use a medium layer brush for this, as it's not too big or too small, it's just a good size, and it gets a nice point to it, because we've got a few areas now around the model that, like the white flame and stuff, we don't want to transfer any of this wash onto. So as always, just get some on your palette, like so. Get my bristle to a nice point, and I'll start applying it. I'll just start on his helmet first. And like before, just take your time, don't rush. Getting around to these areas will be a bit tricky, so just this is where you probably need to be a little bit more patient and just take your time. And if you do splodge, you can just neaten him back up again. Once the Agrax Earth Shade is dry, we're going to move on to using some Norn Oil just for some of those deep recesses, just to give a bit more contrast, as we still want it to look rusty. So I'm just going to apply some to my palette, like so. Add a little touch of water. Again, get your brush to a nice point. I'm using a medium layer still for this, because it's just as good. So I'll just twist it around, and we'll just apply it. I'm going to mainly concentrate on the helmet. So just where the eye holes are, and around some of the little joins. Again, you don't have to go too mad. And as I said before, if you do splodge, just go back over, go the previous colour. And also around the railings as well. Just add a little bit in there. With that shade now dry, we're going to apply some nylock oxide. We're just going to apply this into some of the crevices and recesses where all the pits and damage is, because it will keep that ancient feel to it. So I'm just going to slap some into the corner of the palette here. Still using my medium layer brush because it gives me a bit more control. And then we'll just start applying it to the model. So on the wings, you've got like some little pitted bits. I've been eaten away with rust and damage over the years. And I've just applied some of the cracks as well. If you look at the sword, you've got a couple of like little pits there as well. And with the chain mail, to go to the back, it's probably just actually worth running it just like the top parts of it, but still showing some like silver. With the nylock oxide now applied and dry, we're ready to move on to the next stage. And for this, we're going to use Stormo Silver. We're going to pick out all those hard edges and just pick out some rivets and stuff, just as like key highlights. For this, I'll use a small layer brush. I'll just apply some to my palette. Just thin it down slightly as well, because you don't want it to be too thick and goopy. And now I'm just, to get a nice point, just going to keep twisting those bristles until I'm happy, like so. And then we'll start applying. So we're doing edge highlights, especially hard edges like this, just use the edge of the brush like so. Don't use the tip, because it gives you more control and you get a nice consistent line as well like that. So like here. A little trick for doing chainmail is that it's almost like a little bit of a dry brush. So just rub a bit off my bristles, and then what you can do is just run it down and it will just pick out some of those key areas. With the silvers now finished, we're going to move on to the next stage, which is the brass areas. The areas such as the sword hilt and some of the details on the scabbard. For this, we're going to use Balthazar Gold as a base. We'll then wash all over with Agrax Earth Shade. Then to give a nice ancient worn feel, we'll use Nylock Oxide again, and then highlight up with Stormo Silver. So first of all, I'm going to start base coating with Balthazar Gold. I'll use a medium layer as well. And as always, just apply some to your palette with a little touch of water, just to have it a little bit thinner. And then to get it to a nice point. I'm using a medium layer just because I can get more on the bristles as well, but I can still get a nice point to it. And I'll just start painting that up. Don't worry if it's too thin, because you can do a couple of coats here. Just take your time. And the details on the scabbard is this area here, and just a bit at the bottom there. With the base coat now dry, I'm just going to start applying the Agrax Surf Shade just over all those areas. And I'm going to use a medium layer for this as well. Once the shade's dry, we're going to start applying Nylac Oxide like we did with the silver, just to give it that ancient, worn feel. And just apply it over quite liberally with a medium layer. With the Nylac Oxide applied, I'm just going to start highlighting select areas with Stormhost Silver. For this, I'll be using a small layer brush, and I'll also be picking out those details on the scabbard as well. And as you can see, the Knight of Shrouds is almost finished. All that's left to do is the stonework on his base. And for this, we're going to use Mechanica Standard Grey as a base coat. We'll then wash with Agrax Surf Shade and then do a little bit of highlighting with Dawnstone. So first of all, let's start base coating it. So I'm using a small base coat brush. Let's get some Mechanica Standard on there. I'll thin this down a little bit, actually. So it's a little bit more runny, just because it'll allow me to get into those recesses a bit easier as well. So I'll just get enough on my brush and I'll start applying it. As you can see, the bit at the front here is dead easy. You can just slap that straight on, no problems. However, the part just at the back here, you'll just need to be a bit careful. As you can see, I just did a little splodge there, but I'll just tidy that back up with a bit of Orthwin. Try not to get too excited like me. With the base coat applied and any smudges corrected, I'm now going to start applying Agrax Surf Shade. Again, just liberally apply it on, and do try and be careful, not like me where I keep splodging. And for this, I'm just going to use a medium layer brush. Once the Agrax Earth Shade is thoroughly dry, we'll start highlighting with Dawnstone. Now for this, I am just using the edge of the brush. You could dry brush it, but the danger there is you might get on the flames around this area. So it's your choice. You could tidy up after, but I'm just going to use a small layer brush for this. And just pick out those raised details on the edges, and you can just use the side of your brush for that. And with that, the Knight of Shrouds is completed. All that's left is to base the model, and I recommend doing this in the colour scheme of your army. With the model now painted and based, the Knight of Shrouds is now ready to lead the legions of Nagash into battle. There are a couple of things to remember when following this paint guide. Firstly, when using any shades, especially around other light areas, just take your time as neatness is key. You don't want to contaminate those areas. Secondly, with the shades, give plenty of time to dry as well. And lastly, when using any metallics, just change your water regularly, as you don't want to contaminate those other colours. Hope you guys have enjoyed this paint guide, and I hope to see you soon. Bye bye.